call them up and say happy Monday. Tell them I'm in friends, also tell them your enemies. Once again, it's your friend, brother, and humble servant Roosevelt, coming back at you with another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning into the program on today. And if you're not yet a subscriber to Roosevelt Sounds Off, please, ma'am, please, sir, go down and hit that subscribe button along with the bell icon. This way you'll be notified anytime I drop a brand new video right here on YouTube. Hopefully everyone had a great weekend. Hopefully you had some fun and so maybe some relaxation with your family. You know, weather-wise, it's still kind of cold here in Chicago for May. But, you know, hopefully everyone out there is okay. Hopefully you are doing everything that you need to do to build up your own life. It's good to see you all out here on today. And most of all, happy Monday and happy May. Okay, gonna get into what I want to talk about on today. Because actually, this video really should have been done by Friday. But I guess yours truly has just been sitting down trying to relax, relate, and release. With the change in the weather, it seems like I got a little bit of a head cold or slightly hoarse. You notice my voice is a little bit off, but you know, don't worry, you all, like always, together, we're going to get through it, okay? And basically, the reason why this was supposed to be released on Friday, because Friday, which was April 29th, it commemorates something, I don't want to say necessarily special, but something that happened within the history of this country. April 29th commemorates the 30th anniversary of the 1992 Los Angeles riots. Oh yes, ladies and gentlemen, it has been 30 years. Oh boy, I cannot believe it. Because back in April of 92, I was just a junior getting ready to come out of high school. And a whole lot of you all who are maybe watching this video could be younger. You know, some of y'all are in your 30s or 20s, and maybe some of you all weren't even born or very, very young when the LA riots occurred. But I definitely remember it vividly. In case you don't remember, it's basically pretty much a rebellion and an uprising in Los Angeles after four Los Angeles police officers were acquitted for beating up Rodney King. And, you know, as you know, that the video was caught on, it was caught on video. But even though it was caught on video and it showed these officers beating him up and brutalizing him, they still found these officers not guilty. Now, to this day, I can't figure out why, but that is the situation, and that's what happened. And that's what set a whole lot of stuff off in Los Angeles. Also, because usually I have found that whenever there's like a massive uprising or, you know, a whole lot of things, basically you only have to look back because there was a whole lot of other stuff going on at the time. Because this was around a time that black people in South Central Los Angeles were having problems with the police department. This is why, even before Rodney King, in 1988, NWA made the rap song, F the Police. And they were talking about, you know, the illegal tactics of the Los Angeles Police Department, the racist tactics of the Los Angeles Police Department, and how they beat people up every single day in South Central LA. The only difference is, with Rodney King, it got peeped out by somebody's home video camera. So by it being on video, there you had proof positive that black people were not making this stuff up, and black people and even other people were not lying about the racism and brutality of the Los Angeles Police Department. But yet this stuff was really, really happening. And these four officers were found not guilty. And also too, before that, before I go too far, a teenager named Latasha Harlins was also killed by Soo Jeon Do, who was a Korean grocery store owner, because she told this lie trying to say that Latasha Harlins, who was black, was trying to steal a bottle of orange juice. And there have always been mounting tensions in between black residents and Korean store owners. So all of this stuff just exploded and came to a head in April of 1992. You know, just like a whole lot of stuff exploded almost 2 years ago after the death of George Floyd, who was murdered by Minneapolis ex-police officer Derek Chauvin. You have to take into consideration why they were rioting and looting all over this country. I mean, there was riots here in Chicago, New York, St. Louis, Memphis, Dallas, Los Angeles, Miami. It just goes on and on and on. Because you have to also consider what was happening in the world around the time of George Floyd's death. You know, first of all, we had a president in office, you know, who didn't care anything about us. Even though this particular president that we have in office right now still doesn't care anything about us, but I'll talk about that more later. And you also had the impact of COVID-19. You know, during the lockdowns and all of that stuff, people lost their jobs. People went into depression. Some people might have turned to drugs. Some people couldn't make money. Some people got put out on the street. And when we saw on video this happened to George Floyd, then to all of us, that was like the straw that broke the camel's back. I'm sorry. So, excuse me. In between 1992 and 2022, we have to ask ourselves the question, has things really changed? And have we really learned anything in the last 30 years? Because right now, I'm going to bring to you a short clip, because like I said, this video is not going to be so long. And this was of a young man who is black, who is handcuffed by some white officers, and they think he's somebody else, but in reality, you know, he's not what they're looking for. All I know is that, you know, he's cussing their behinds out. So, hey, stay tuned for this clip, and I'll come right back and tell you what I think.
Your name is fuck.
I'm a Susan, bro. You know that, right? You know that, right?
Your name is fuck.
You know I'm a Susan, right? Yeah, you sit there and got nothing. Be quiet. You want to, your dumb ass.
That's all they
he just told.
That's all they
got me in handcuffs for nothing, bro. My name David Thomas. You know who the fuck I am. What the fuck is wrong with these motherfuckers, bro? What a guy, bro.
I
swear to God,
man, like fuck with me, bro. Look what they do. He gonna jump out and hop out on.
Catch from them motherfuckers out, dude.
Caught me the mother that was punching me in the shit, bro. On God, bro. Push that.
We all
what the hell is he still in handcuffs for, man?
Exactly.
It don't take that long to search no goddamn name.
If he go, I'm going with him. Straight the fuck up.
I done put one out on you already, bro. I'm gonna put out another one, bro. Because y'all locked me off for no reason. Talking about some fucking David Thomas from Arkansas. Had me in jail for 3 days for nothing. Now you doing this dumb ass shit again, bro. Why you keep fucking with me, bro? Why you keep fucking with me, though? Why?
I bet she gonna get out of the handcuffs and come right the fuck, huh?
You work for
have.
Us, bro. You pay your clown ass cash, bro.
Oh, shit.
He ain't even got no motherfucking internet in the store.
Hey man, that man named David Thomas, man. What the hell y'all got going on?
Yeah, Thomas, who the fuck is the Angelo Lewis?
I don't know who the fuck that is.
That? Bro, you know who I am. You sit here holding me in handcuffs. TG11 know who I am too. So y'all both look stupid as fuck, bro. He just locked me up. October the 15th came to my house. Know my name and everything. How the fuck you got me in handcuffs? Now let me fuck go. Let me go. How you feel? How you feel? How you feel? How you feel though? You know who the fuck I am, bro. Don't play with me like that, bro. For real, though. You got me fucked up, bro. I'm telling you. Don't fuck with me no more. I'm telling you, it's the last one, bro. Fuck with me no more, bro. You just got to put your hand on your gear all you want to. Yeah. I don't give a fuck. I'm telling y'all, y'all better leave me the fuck alone.
Baby,
I ain't calm down shit for what? What you mean? You got me locked up for nothing, bro.
You better turn the fuck around.
I ain't
around.
About to do shit. What you gonna do?
You want this cuff
what
up?
You gonna do?
Turn around.
Fuck wrong with you. You got me locked up for no special reason. Ain't nothing you can do but let me the fuck alone.
There you go.
Fuck off me. I'm telling you, but don't fuck with me no more. Don't fuck with me no more. Don't fuck with me no more now. It's the last goddamn warning, my boy.
Back
pussy bitch. You pussy ass bitch. You too, Ellie, you bitch! Punk motherfucker!
What the fuck is up with the fuck?
Okay, and we are back, and that particular clip falls under the category of fair use. So you see, in 2022, you see how these officers are handling this young man. And, you know, this is just only a microcosm of many stuff or many things that have happened over the years. You know, we've had the shooting of Michael Brown and Tamir Rice and Eric Garner, Rekia Boyd, Tatiana Jefferson, Breonna Taylor, Sandra Bland. And this stuff continues on to happen over and over and over again because the system of policing in 30 years has not changed. Police are still brutal. Police are still, you know, hard on us. Even though I can definitely understand, looking at it on the other side, that there is a certain segment of us, should we say, that counterculture, that, you know, we'll go out and commit crimes and could be bad people who do bad things. But I think the mistake is that police officers, after working in the field for so long, that they begin to look at all of us as bad people who do bad things, because after a while of so many years on the job, and maybe you've seen a whole lot of bad things, that you might get jaded and begin to think that everyone is this way. And no, everyone is not this way. And I get so tired of people when they always act like, you know, we're always supposed to give the police officers the benefit of the doubt because, you know, they're only human and they can make mistakes and you can't paint every single police officer with a big and broad brush. But someone needs to tell them that they can't paint us with a big and broad brush either. And you know, you have another group of people always saying, well, if police think that they're in danger, they're going to shoot first and ask questions later. Because one thing about the police, they're not going to let you hurt them because they got families too. They want to get home to their families. I mean, but us as the citizens want to be able to get home to our families as well. But it seems like the police officers are the only ones who get the benefit of the doubt. And it seems like being a police officer is the only job where you can come to work and you can have a bad day and take it out on anybody who you want to. And it's automatically excused. It's the only job where you can come and yell at someone or curse at someone. And you get a chance to still keep your job and no one ever questions it. But yet, if you were, let's just say, a worker at Walmart or McDonald's, or let's just say just the average person who's maybe working in a law office or a dental office or something like that, you can't come to work and just because you had a bad day, take it out on someone at your job. You can't come to work and curse out your customers or your clients. Because why? That's a good way to get yourself fired. But yet police officers do these kinds of things and these evil things over and over and over and over again, and they're never punished for it. And this is where I get a chance to talk about our current president. Good place to say it right here. You know, well, at least all of you all who have been watching me for a while know my stance on Joseph Biden. I find him to be a low-down, evil, rabid racist who was mentored by Strom Thurmond and trained by Robert Byrd, two high-ranking members in the Ku Klux Klan, and a whole lot of black people, a whole lot of you stupid, ignorant black people, went out of your way to go and vote for this man without even requiring anything for your vote. The only thing a whole lot of stupid Negroes went and did was just get so over emotional because they didn't want Donald Trump. So they went out and just, instead of just staying home from the polls, just went and voted for Biden without looking up this man's background, without studying every single thing that he's ever done, every single thing that he's ever said. I didn't vote for him because I knew exactly what he would do. I knew that he would possibly, even though he tried to lie and say that he wasn't going to do it in the beginning, I knew that he would put COVID mandates in effect. I knew that there would be no reparations for blacks. I knew that he would not defund or punish police officers or end qualified immunity the way he was supposed to. I knew that these things, but a whole lot of you people out there who voted for him act like you didn't know it. But as you see, over a year in, you see he has done everything else for everyone else, including Asians, LGBTs, and pretty much done things to keep abortion legal. And now with this war breaking out in Ukraine, he just sent them over billions and trillions of dollars. But still, nothing being done for black people. I wonder why. So I just said all of that just to say this. One thing that we want as black people, I'm not trying to say that we don't need a society with police. Yes, officers and police are needed, but we want the good ones. We don't want officers who are going to brutalize us, officers who are going to hurt us, officers who are going to unjustly kill us. And we need an immediate end to qualified immunity. For all of y'all who don't know, qualified immunity is the protection that police officers get even when they do something wrong. They can hide behind qualified immunity and they don't have to face any charges, or they won't get fired and they'll never be penalized or punished. We need our president to issue an executive order, like he's issued an executive order to pass the Asian hate crime bill, to do things for people in Ukraine, to do things for LGBT. No, we need something just for us, for punishment for the police whenever they get out of line. And to this day, this is something that Joseph Biden has not done. Matter of fact, he says that he doesn't want to defund the police. He doesn't want to end qualified immunity. If anything, he wants to give the police more funding. But yet, a whole lot of you all, especially black people, thought that he'd be a whole lot less racist than Trump. I don't think so. So that's what we need. I mean, yeah, he might have done something like make Juneteenth a federal holiday and all of that kind of stuff. But you notice something about these politicians, be they Republican or Democrat, that they always give us what they want to give us, but not what we asked for. We did not ask for Juneteenth to be a federal holiday. We want reparations and we want punishment for the police. We want an immediate end to police brutality and an immediate end to qualified immunity. So, as far as I'm concerned, nothing has changed, because during the LA riots, 1992, it was George Bush Sr., who was a Republican, who was in power. So now under Biden, it's still the same way. It's still the exact same way. And this last clip I'm going to play you is of a police chief talking about how all of us and everybody, they condemn the police. But yet along with it, you're going to see some of the brutal actions that police perform upon people. Oh yeah, you're going to love this one. Please stay tuned for this clip and view with discretion is advised.
Everybody's trying to shame us. The legislators. The press.
Oh my God.
Everybody's trying to shame us. Into being embarrassed.
Oh my fucking God.
Well, you know what? This isn't stained. It's still got a shine on it. Stop treating us like animals and thugs. Start treating us with some respect. It's disgusting. Trying to make us embarrassed of our profession. Don't resist! Don't resist! Don't resist! Don't resist, bro!
I'm not!
And that's all I have to say.
Oh yes, and we are back. And that clip, of course, falls under the category of fair use. So, with all of that being done, with all of that being said, a whole lot of you all will probably want to know my answer to that question. Has anything changed? And have we learned anything over the last 30 years? As you see, that we still have police brutality within this country. Police sometimes still continue on to get it wrong a whole lot of times. And because of our president, Joseph Biden, we do not have an immediate end to qualified immunity. And we always want to give police officers an excuse and the benefit of the doubt. And right now on social media, they are watching out for certain channels they say that spread certain misinformation or disinformation. I guess when it comes down, especially nowadays with a hot button issue like the COVID-19 vaccine. They say that if you say something bad about the vaccine or say something that's quite not true or give your opinion on it, then hey, that's misinformation. But the mainstream media puts out misinformation all of the time. You know, misinformation, you know, like Officer Darren Wilson against Mike Brown feared for his life. Misinformation. Timothy Loman, when he shot Tamir Rice, who was a little kid just carrying a squirt gun, feared for his life. Misinformation again. Derek Chauvin, when he put his knee on the neck of George Floyd for 8 minutes and 45 seconds, feared for his life. Misinformation. When those Kentucky police officers shot up the house and came to the wrong house and ended up killing Breonna Taylor, you know, they had to shoot because they feared for their lives. Complete misinformation. Joseph Biden is gonna do so much for us black people that Trump was not doing. And even though we know that we gave him our vote, and by us as black people giving him our vote, then he is obligated to do something for us. Complete and total misinformation. Now, you see how much misinformation is spread through the mainstream media. All these lies. So in between 1992 and 2022, we still have some of the same stuff that is going on right now that it was back then, 30 years ago. And I can't believe it that Rodney King is dead and gone, but yet we are still dealing with some of these unequalities in the criminal justice system, just like he did 30 years ago. The only way that even he won something back then was through a civil judgment, because in a civil case, the burden of proof is not as strong as it is in the criminal case. So he, you know, he just won some money, whatever like that. But after that, he still suffered with nightmares, still suffered with depression, all over what happened to him at the hands of these four Los Angeles disgraced pigs in blue. And no one wants to talk about it. No one wants to deal with it at all. So you ask me, has things changed in the last 30 years? My answer would just about be absolutely no. Everything is still the same. Because if things changed, we would not have police officers getting away with mistreating the public. If things have changed, it would be no way that a police officer who has 10 to 15 criminal complaints can remain on the street serving the public. If things have changed, these officers would still not have qualified immunity and protection, even when they go and do something completely wrong or against policy. Because you all on your job, you all can't do something wrong or against policy, because they will say that you're a bad worker. You get written up. You get fired. You be unemployed, unemployable, all of that. But these police officers can just keep on going and just keep on messing up. And the worst part about it is when good officers don't turn in bad officers. Because I get so tired of a whole lot of people telling me, well, you know, Roosevelt, or every single police officer is not bad. But you're bad whenever you don't turn in another bad person. And even when you find some good officers who want to do the right things and even turn in a bad cop, it's almost like everything rains down on this good officer. The officer, good officers, they're never going to be rewarded. They're going to be punished by their fellow officers, because it's an evil culture within the police department. Because why in 30 or more years, the system of justice in this country has not changed. It's still the exact same way. So no, there really haven't been any changes in the last 30 years. And I really don't believe police officers have done or learned anything in the last 30 years. The only time that they tend to straighten up and want to get better is when there's an uprising. Because if things don't change, and if this kind of bad behavior that you have seen or that I've showed you in these two clips in this video today don't change, then hey, what can I say? You might as well just get ready for the next riot and the next uprising. So all of that being said, this will conclude today's episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. And if you like this video, please do me a favor, give me a thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. And please tune in next time for another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. And until the next video, this has been your friend, brother, and humble servant Roosevelt, saying peace and blessings to all of you and your families.